Hey, happy Sunday. I'm Chelsea from thestudentarchitect.com, where I create software tutorials and provide a variety of resources for architects and architecture students. If you're looking to gain a more foundational knowledge of Revit, then I highly recommend checking out my Foundations of Revit course at thestudentarchitect.com/classes. So today we're going to talk about how to add property lines in Revit. So I'm just going to zoom in here so we can see a little bit better. So if right now you're using detail lines to put in your property lines, I'm happy to tell you there is a better way. So using detail lines is really not the best option because detail lines are 2D elements that only exist within that specific view. So if you wanted to add those property lines onto your first floor plan, as well as your site plan, as well as your proposed site plan, that's a lot of copy and pasting, and that leaves a lot of potential for error, like things getting moved or deleted and things like that, which is something we definitely don't want. So you can see I have my existing site plan as well as my proposed site plan, and these 2D detail line property lines are only showing up on the existing plan and not on the proposed plan. So if I wanted them to show up on the proposed plan, again, I would need to copy and paste them. And that's really not the best way. So luckily there is a better way. So what we can do is go up to the site tab up on the ribbon and you'll see property lines. There's an option for property lines here. So you can either click on the icon here or you can use my custom keyboard shortcut PL on the keyboard. So I'm going to hit PL to go to the keyboard shortcut, and you'll see there's a couple of ways that you can add in these property lines. You can either create it by entering your distances and bearings, or you can do a free sketch. So if you have site survey drawings or something like that where you do have those coordinates, then using the distances and bearings would be a good idea, but if not, then you can just do create by sketching. So property lines, unlike most sketch elements in Revit, do not have to form a closed loop, but they cannot intersect with one another. So if I quickly just draw in a rectangle here and delete one of these lines, hit OK, you'll see that it will allow us to create this property line, but it is giving us a warning here saying that the property lines do not close, form a closed loop. And so if you're looking for areas based on your property lines, you won't be able to get that. It won't be able to calculate the area because it's not an enclosed space. So if I double click to go back into that sketch, you'll see if I close this off and then try to put in some other mark here, try to hit OK, it's going to say there's an error. It won't let us complete the sketch because it doesn't allow intersecting lines. So I can either quit or hit continue. Let's continue. I'm just going to do a cross section here to select all of them and delete. And this time I'm going to use the pick lines tool. I'll hover over one of these detail lines that I have and hit my tab key to select all of the lines in that chain. Click my mouse and then hit OK. And now you can see if we look at the proposed plan, you'll see that I drew it in the existing plan, but you'll also see it show up in the proposed plan. So that's really the benefit of using the property line tool, is that you're not copying and pasting, it's an actual element within your model. Now, if for any reason I decide that I want to hide the property lines, I can either go to Visibility Graphics, or you'll see that it's grayed out because in this case I have a view template applied to this view. So in this case, I can go over to the Properties panel and click on my view template, go to Model Overrides, hit SI on the keyboard to jump down to the site category, hit the plus to expand the options, and uncheck property lines. Hit Apply, and then you'll see the property lines go away. I'm just going to cancel that and you'll see them come back. Now it's really up to you what you want to do for your setback lines. You can either go ahead and keep using your detail lines, or you could try out using property lines and changing the line type. So if we double click into this view here, hit PL on the keyboard for the property line shortcut, we'll create by sketching. Hit the pick line tool here. Again, I'll hover over one of the lines, then hit my tab key, and then hit OK. And now I can right-click on that on the property line, override graphics and view by element, and I can change the projection line from by style to whichever line that I want to. So we'll just go with a dash right now, hit OK. And that's a little bit hard to see because we have some overlapping lines here. But you'll notice that that is a view by view change here. We overrode the graphics on the existing site plan, but that didn't change anything for the proposed site plan. So we'll have to redo that change here. So again, I'll hover over the setback line, right click, go to override graphics and view by element. Again, we'll go to projection lines and change that to a dashed line, hit OK. And now you can see that these are two different line types. So this could be helpful to use the property line to be able to see your setback lines on all of your floor plans or different floor plans. Or if you decide that that's not something that you need, then you can go ahead and keep using your detail lines for those. I really hope that you found this video helpful, and if you did, please hit that like button because it really helps out my channel and helps me know that you like videos like this. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe and make sure that you turn on the bell so that you get notified when I post new videos. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next Sunday.